From Central Ohio's news leader, this is 10 TV News at 11.
From rainy to slick during the evening commute, as night fell, raindrops turned into snowflakes, and the drive got dicier and dicier.
Many of you rushed to the windows and captured the first big snow of the season, from Dublin to Columbus to New Albany to Blacklick. It's a pretty sight, but a little snow can cause some big problems.
It can. Emergency and road crews are just getting to work now. Our team is also busy making sure you're safe and ahead of the snow. We're seeing how conditions are on the highways.
But we want to start with Ashley Barrasey and the latest snowfall totals. Ashley?
Yeah, we are definitely seeing quite a bit of snow falling throughout the area, and we'll continue to do so as we go into tonight. So let's start by looking at those latest snowfall reports around Central Ohio. Bell Fountain already reporting 3 inches of snow. Urbana, Delaware, Upper Arlington already at an inch. Columbus over at John Glenn Columbus International Airport, just over a half of an inch, making this the first measurable snowfall of the season. And Circleville right around a half of an inch of snow. Our radar over the last 3 hours has shown how that rain has transitioned into snow. So putting our live Doppler 10 radar on right now, you can see how snow has really encompassed a widespread area around Central Ohio, all the way up towards Marion, through Mount Vernon, Newark, down towards Chillicothe, and as far west as Urbana and Bell Fountain. That rain snow line off to our far east, getting closer to I-77. So Cambridge probably dealing with a little mixture right now, as is parts of Coshocton County. So we're under a winter weather advisory right now until 8 o'clock tomorrow morning. That means that road conditions could be hazardous, especially tonight, as a lot of the surfaces are expected to refreeze, given that temperatures are going to take a dip. In fact, they should dip below the freezing mark into the 20s. So we're looking at about 23 degrees by the time you wake up at 6 o'clock tomorrow morning. Right now, though, we're sitting at 28, but with winds out of the northwest around 12 miles per hour, it feels more like 18 degrees with the wind chill, and it's just going to get more frigid from here. By tomorrow morning at 6 o'clock, a lot of us will be waking up to single-digit wind chills. Folks, this is the coolest air that we have felt so far this season. So not only are we dealing with the first measurable snow, we're dealing with the coldest temperatures, typically temperatures you would see January and beyond. We'll talk about how long we're going to stay in this deep freeze and how long the snow sticks around coming up in your full forecast.
All right, thanks, Ashley. Well, a number of schools are delayed tomorrow, and that includes Buckeye Central Schools, Ridgedale Local Schools, and Kenton City Schools. And those are just a few. More are scrolling at the bottom of your screen, and we'll, of course, be updating those overnight. Hundreds of ODOT crews are taking to the highways tonight.
And the drop in the temperature could make their jobs harder. 10 TV's Angela Reichert got a firsthand look at what they do. She has a look at the roads right now. Angela?
Hi, Jerry. Yeah, we are on 70 eastbound headed toward downtown Columbus. I got to tell you, we've been on the road for quite some time tonight, and things are definitely starting to stick here. We actually just passed a few moments ago a car that went off the side of the road here. I'd venture to say folks are starting to see some of those troubles that Ashley talked about. But earlier today when I was on the road with ODOT, I got to see what they see. I was with District 6. They cover 8 counties, including Franklin County. They actually have about 30 crews out tonight. They're trying to keep you and your family safe, but they say they do need a little bit of your help with that.
For the Ohio Department of Transportation, it's go time.
In my four seasons, this is definitely the earliest we've had a storm hit.
Dan Marshall is one of dozens of drivers out treating Central Ohio roads. Salt and brine ready to go.
I'll hit the bridges and overpasses. They'll freeze first.
This is what he sees. He has to navigate not only the snow, ice, and construction, but also all of us.
Yeah, definitely just give us as much space as you can. Front, back, side to side. Try and pay attention to our signals. I know we got a lot of flashing lights going on, so it can be hard to see the turn signals, but they're back there and they're red. Nobody wants the accident.
A good reminder, as this is only the start. Chances are we'll see more of the white stuff and more of them.
If we're fully into the storm, we do 16-hour shifts, 8 hours off, back in for another 16 if we need to.
It's hard but rewarding, knowing he plays a small part in keeping your family safe.
Absolutely. That's the most rewarding part of it. We've all got family and friends that travel these same roads.
Now, when I was out with them earlier, the pavement, it wasn't quite hitting that freezing mark, but of course that could happen overnight, so you really do need to be careful out here. I'm told they will be working, though, until this storm quits. I'll send it back to you in the studio.
All right. Thank you, Angela. And as that snow piles up outside your home, you might be wondering when it will be cleared up. Well, here's a live look at the Columbus Snow Warriors map tonight. These are the city snow plows, and right now, only a few crews are working out on the roads right now. You can find your neighborhood's priority on 10tv.com/featured links.
Now, several sheriff's offices are warning about driving conditions. Delaware, Champaign, Morrow counties, all under a level one snow emergency tonight, as you see on this map. That means the roads could be dangerous, so take it slow.
Well, bridges and overpasses, they are pretty slick tonight. Here's what drivers were dealing with in Bridge Park in Dublin. You can see more of those slushy conditions as people made their way home. Heading to Blacklick now, where the snow was coming down pretty fast out that way, covering the ground with a good coating of snow. You can see the wind blowing those flurries around in this neighborhood off Wagoner Road tonight.
And the wintry weather is causing some delays for travelers. At last check, about 25 flights were delayed coming into Columbus overnight. We are not the only community dealing with dangerous conditions, though. Hillary Lane reports from New York.
Snow is blanketing parts of Michigan Monday night as an Arctic air mass settles over much of the country, bringing record-breaking cold. Monday snowfall caught some residents off guard.
Came a little too soon. I don't have my scraper. I don't know where my boots are.
I kind of feel like we skipped fall this year.
This hardware store manager said it was a quick turnaround.
It went from selling a ton of rakes on Saturday to selling a ton of snow shovels and snow blowers today.
Chicago commuters also got off to a cold, wet start.
I've been here 6 years. I've never experienced winter coming so early.
More than 2,000 flights were canceled at Chicago's O'Hare Airport, but not before a plane slid off the runway on its second attempt to land.
Once the plane actually landed, the plane did not grab a hold of the ground.
We didn't know what was coming. A lot of people were bracing for it, grabbing the seats in front of us, especially the ones that were going sideways towards the window.
Icy roads were blamed for numerous crashes in the Midwest. Treacherous conditions could continue, with some areas getting a foot of snow or more in the system, plus brutal cold.
Right now, the coldest air anywhere in our country is in Fargo, where it feels like, again, this is temperature combined with wind chill, it feels like one degree in Fargo.
222 million people will experience temperatures below freezing by Thursday. Hillary Lane, CBS News.
And our 10 This Morning team is starting a little early tomorrow to get you off to a good start. Check in with Angela, Pete, and the team starting at 4 a.m. for the latest forecast, traffic, and top stories.
Well, new tonight, former President Jimmy Carter is in the hospital. He'll have a procedure done in the morning to relieve pressure on his brain. Carter has fallen at least three times this year. The first incident in the spring required hip replacement surgery. Then he was briefly hospitalized after fracturing his pelvis last month. Those falls led to bleeding that caused swelling in the brain. Carter is a fighter. He received a dire cancer diagnosis back in 2015, but survived and has since said he is cancer-free. At 95, Carter is the oldest living ex-president. Well, two veterans with a business idea.
And now they've cooked up a reality.
For pretty much as long as we remembered, we wanted to, you know, open up a pizza shop. Pepperoni
and the bond between these men, firing up delicious food.
And ahead in sports, hanging up his helmet, the ice ahead after a loss for the Columbus Blue Jackets.
And it's like we flipped a switch and now we are in full-blown winter. Cooler air moving in as well as some snow showers. This is a sneak peek at the week ahead. Slippery conditions as you wake up tomorrow before giving way to partly sunny skies, but staying chilly through the middle of this week, well below average temperatures, and then we'll eventually get a little more sunshine on Saturday, but we still remain below average. Just how cool will it be? We'll have the details in your full forecast coming up after the break.
Fall weather around here can change in an instant. Depend on the Doppler 10 weather team to keep you prepared. At home, at work, or on the go, stay one step ahead.
Tomorrow morning as you drive into work
with the Doppler 10 weather team.
The Germain family is excited to announce that the Hatfield Auto Mall at Georgesville Road is now the Germain Auto Mall. Hatfield Volkswagen is now Germain Volkswagen, and we're thrilled to welcome the VW store into our family. Get started at germainvolkswagen.com.
Alexa, turn on the house lights.
Right now, get 0% for 60 months, plus $1,500 cash back, or $4,500 cash back on a 2019 Ford Escape.
What are the signs of a foundation problem? Cracks can be in inside drywall or outside masonry. They can be in block or poured concrete. They can be vertical or horizontal. But they all have two things in common. One, they get worse if you ignore them. And two, they keep stealing value from your home until the cause is fixed. So stop letting your money fall through the cracks. Call Ohio Basement Authority today and let the area's most trusted experts restore your home's value.
Well, yeah, there's some old prescription pills, but my son's a good kid. He's not going to look for them.
Two-thirds of teens who abuse opioids get them from friends and family. Don't live in denial, Ohio. Dispose of your leftover pills.
There's more food shared on social media than we know what to do with. But still, one out of eight people are unsure where their next meal will come from. This holiday season, for every food photo you post with the hashtag MeyerSimplyGive, Meyer will donate a meal to help feed a local family in need. Don't just share the photo, share the meal.
I did some early shopping this year. One for you, one for me.
I love it. I got us a little something too.
Yeah?
Yep. One for you, and one for me.
I love it.
Oh, actually, that was supposed to be for me.
I love it.
I like red.
Step up to GMC and get 12% below MSRP on most 2019 Acadia models. Plus, current eligible non-GM owners get an additional 4% purchase cash. We are professional grade. GMC.
The Germain family is excited to announce that the Hatfield Auto Mall at Georgesville Road is now the Germain Auto Mall. Hatfield Hyundai is now Germain Hyundai, and we're thrilled to welcome the Hyundai store into our family. Get started at germainhyundai.com.
Closed captioning on 10TV is sponsored by Custom Air.
New video into our newsroom tonight of snow falling in the New Albany area. Now, this is the most significant snowfall event we've had yet this season. And we'll hear from Ashley Barrasey in just a moment.
New tonight, police are searching for the gunman who shot a man in the head. It happened earlier this evening on River Creek Bay Way in East Columbus. Medics transported 26-year-old Sean Thompson Jr. to the hospital in critical condition. He's now stable. Anyone with information is asked to call Columbus Police. And a sea of support tonight for a detective killed in the line of duty. A large crowd showed up at a public viewing in honor of Officer George Del Rio. A gunman shot Del Rio to death a week ago as he was responding to a suspected drug house. Officers arrested the suspected gunman. Del Rio's funeral procession will be held tomorrow. And two American heroes, two friends, and one lifelong dream.
On this Veterans Day, we honor everyone who has served our country. Two have achieved their shared goal of serving something else. Bryant Somerville takes us to the intersection of patriotism and pizza.
I think we're going to need to do more larges tonight.
Yeah. I wondered how to start this story.
Did you pick up any fresh spinach from...
Yeah, I got some spinach this morning. Okay.
How to best capture its meaning in one line. And then he said this.
Every pizza tells a story.
Every pizza tells a story, especially when you think about
love.
What makes it?
Fresh ingredients definitely help.
If a pizza could explain Dan Shackelford and Larry Halpin's friendship, it might have toppings of aged provolone or classic pepperoni. You'll understand the symbolism better in just a minute. They both own Giannino's Pizzeria in Pickerington, and they both...
He's just always been there for me. He's a very steadfast fella.
...speak very highly of one another.
And you couldn't ask for a better friend. More loyal, more honest.
That's because this friendship has been baking... for more than 20 years.
Since kindergarten.
Yeah, so probably about 1995, 96. Yeah.
Looks like we got plenty of mac and cheese.
Friends since Mrs. Halliwell's kindergarten class in northern Ohio way back when. As teenagers, they worked for a Giannino's close to where they lived. That's probably when the idea started.
For pretty much as long as we remembered, we wanted to, you know, open up a pizza shop.
But you know what they say about life. It gets in the way. After graduation, Larry enlisted in the Army, where both his grandfathers served. It was a sense of duty, a sense of pride to continue that legacy. After Dan got his high school diploma, he went to college. Years later, he enlisted in the Air Force, following in the military mindset of his father and his uncle. And he became a C-130 engine mechanic.
It was really important to both of us, I think, to have served. There are so many great things about this country, and so many of those aspects we have to defend every single day.
A love of country, a love of tradition. And following their service.
Let's do a deluxe pepperoni and like buffalo chicken.
Making good on their dreams for a love of pizza. The two veterans opened Giannino's in December of last year. Every pizza tells a story. Theirs, they say, would be topped with aged provolone and pepperoni, symbolic of a lifelong classic friendship. In Pickerington, Bryant Somerville, 10TV News.
Well, today for Veterans Day, Giannino's Pizzeria offered a 25% discount to those who served.
Well deserved. Mm-hmm. Let's take a look at some pictures in the Detroit area tonight.
Yeah. Look at this. Oh, boy.
Yeah, that's the train station in Detroit right there.
Okay.
Compliments of WDIV. I actually worked for that station several years ago.
Yeah.
But my folks still live in the area. They have about 7.5 inches of snow outside outside their door. Some friends of our family in Southeast Michigan have about 11 inches of snow. Mm. So I don't think we should be complaining.
Yeah, we can't complain. They have it worse than us.
Absolutely. Chicago did as well, Wisconsin. So we're getting clipped with the same system. It's just not going to bring as big of a punch as the folks to the north. Mm-hmm. But nonetheless, just enough to create some slick spots for tomorrow morning. So of course you want to use that caution out there. But this is officially our first measurable snow of the season. And some folks enjoy it. Take a look at what Kate shared with us on Facebook. Said, happy first snow. So while some of us might be griping and groaning, others do enjoy it. And it kind of gets you maybe into the holiday spirit as we get closer to Thanksgiving and the Christmas holiday. Here's a photo from Marion. Deanna on Facebook sharing this one. Definitely a full coat of snow up in the Marion area. So the farther north you go, the more accumulation you're going to see at the surface. But our visibility has definitely been reduced here downtown. This is time-lapse footage of the downtown area where you can kind of see that skyline come and go. And that's all because of the snow that's been coming down. We get bursts that are a little heavier at times. So putting this in perspective for you, well, winter is arriving early. Our average first snowfall isn't usually until about November 20th. So we are a little bit early for that. Our average first 1-inch snowfall isn't until December 12th. And we're well on our way of getting close to that 1-inch mark. We've already seen more than a half of an inch over at the airport. So we're going to feel more like January by this week because not only are we dealing with the snow, but we're going to have an Arctic blast thanks to a trough in the jet stream. Live radar right now showing how we have widespread snowfall. We have some bands of some heavier snow that are kind of parallel with I-71. So zooming into our map right here, Belle Fountain could be getting a little bit more of that steady snowfall as opposed to maybe the northwestern part of Delaware County. But nonetheless, it is overtaking the area. A little more of a wintry mix from Millersburg to Coshocton going south of I-70. Though snow really encompassing most of that area by McConnellsville through Lancaster all the way to Washington Courthouse and west of 71 towards Dayton. So this winter weather advisory remaining in effect for all these areas shaded in turquoise till about 8 a.m. Tomorrow morning. Some areas could expire just a little bit earlier than that, but overall our snowfall forecast that we're looking at, well, we could have more than 3 inches north of here, maybe just about an inch here in Columbus. Some areas getting about 2 inches, but a lot of this is going to push east of 71 just after midnight. A few lake effect streamers early tomorrow morning, but even though we're not getting dumped with a ton of snow, it's just enough to have a refreeze during the overnight when we're talking about this cool air really encompassing our area. So 4 degrees below zero in Bismarck for the air temperature. We're sitting at 28. Chicago's at 15, but that trough will continue to push east, and by tomorrow we could have wind chills in the single digits. We're sitting at 28 right now. That's 22 degrees cooler than where we were this time yesterday, and that's thanks to that northwesterly flow of winds. So as we take a look at what we have going on tonight, falling temperatures with some of those lingering snow showers and a low of 24. Your day planner tomorrow, well, folks, we don't get out of the 20s. It's going to stay bitterly cold. Your full forecast by Wednesday morning, air lows in the teens. We will have highs right around freezing, staying in the 30s throughout most of the week and not getting back in the 40s until Saturday and Sunday. But we should be in the mid-50s this time of year. So that's a nice long stretch of below average temperatures.
Yeah.
And as you see at the bottom of your screen, we're rolling the delays for schools tomorrow. So you want to pay attention to that in the morning.
And yeah, bundle those kids up, you know?
Yeah, and it's just so early. Got to pull out the coats and the hats and everything.
I looked out the window and there's snow out there.
Yeah, there is. And on the cars.
A lot of white snow.
It is white. Yeah.
I don't particularly care for it.
Me either.
Well, the Buckeye football team waiting for word on Chase Young and when he might return. Plus, the news is not good for the Blue Jackets and, in particular, team captain Nick Foligno. We'll have that and much more coming up next in sports.
You got me. What do you want? I've got AI robots. I've got VR goggles.
I want your sled, please.
No.
Be a shame if this went viral.
For those who never compromise, the Mercedes-Benz Winter Event.
It was pretty good this year.
Lease the GLE 350 4MATIC SUV for $689 a month at the Mercedes-Benz Winter Event.
Better. It's what we do at Adam H. 30-plus not-for-profit agencies supporting those with mental illness and helping people live addiction-free lives. Helping more people get the help they need to live fuller, healthier, happier lives. To get better. The Alcohol, Drug, and Mental Health Board of Franklin County, where better begins.
National Holidays expert Mary Mary here with a list of holidays you won't want to miss. Get your Ohio Lottery Merry Million Scratch-Offs for
National Donut Day,
National Have a Party with Your Bear Day,
Pickle Day,
National Unique Talent Day,
Take a Hike Day,
and America's favorite, National Jukebox Day. Every day is a reason to celebrate. Grab a Merry Millions and other Ohio Lottery Holiday Scratch-Offs today.
Your voice lets him know he's safe. Shelter Insurance does the same for you. Roadside assistance provided by Road America is now included with your auto policy. We'll take care of you.
Thank you.
While you take care of what's most important. We're your shield. We're your shelter.
World-class heart care is closer than you think.
Cleveland Clinic is number one in the country for hearts. They've saved my life.
With Cleveland Clinic, you'll have a team specialized in the world's most complex heart cases with an unparalleled record of successful treatments and access to the most advanced heart technology. It's why we're the nation's number one heart program 25 years in a row. If you have a heart condition or need a second opinion, call Cleveland Clinic, 833-856-CARE.
Get a 2019 Ford F-150 for $299 a month for 24 months.
How you doing tonight? Dom Tiberi here. Let's talk some sports. Well, Blue Jackets captain Nick Foligno has been suspended for 3 games without pay for elbowing an Avalanche player in this past Saturday's game at Colorado. The hit taking place in the second period, Foligno catching Colorado's Pierre-Edouard Bellemare with an elbow to the head. Bellemare left the game and is now dealing with a concussion. Foligno, who was kicked out of the game, said after the contest that he felt horrible about the hit and that it was not intentional.
I actually didn't know I hit him in the head at all when I went. That's why I was kind of reacting the way I did, and I saw the replay, and there was no intent to hit him like that at all. I mean, I think he, you know, I'm trying to line him up at the time, and then he kind of turns back and makes that play, and it just happened so fast, and I felt, you know, sick to my stomach when I saw that I hit him in the head. And
you know, Foligno's in his 13th season. He's never been suspended before. Well, the Buckeye football team, an impressive win over Maryland on Saturday, beating the Terps 73-14. The offense racking up 705 yards of total offense. The defense had 7 sacks, limiting Maryland to just 139 yards of offense. After the game, you know, most of the talk was about Chase Young, who missed the game because of a possible NCAA infraction. When he will be back, that remains a huge mystery.
He's taking it day to day, and he knows that he has the support of his teammates, and he's going through a tough time. But again, adversity, you know, reveals character. And I can tell you right now, he's a special young man that's handling his business the right way, and we're all proud of him.
Well, the college football playoff ranking will be coming out again tomorrow around 7 p.m. You know, this is the way it looked last week. I expect LSU, though, to be the number one team tomorrow, coming off that big victory over Alabama. I believe the Buckeyes will be second. I think Clemson will be third. And with Penn State losing, I think either Alabama or Georgia, and I think Georgia probably, will be the fourth team. We'll be the fourth team. Well, the OSU men's basketball team off to a perfect 2-0 start. Buckeyes taking care of business at home on Sunday, beating UMass Lowell 76-56. Offensively, junior Caleb Wesson and freshman DJ Carton led the Buckeyes with 13 points each. Chris Holtman says the scoring will need to improve as the season rolls on.
I don't think that we're an offensive juggernaut right now by any stretch, and that sounds like stating the obvious. I'm Mr. Obvious here, but we're not there yet. We're just not there yet.
John Carney sending this Buckeye Pride picture. That is OHIO from Siesta Key, Florida. Mm. They don't have any snow down there, do
they? No, they
sure don't.
Keep the pics coming to my Facebook and Twitter pages.
Boy, that's like painful to watch.
Yes, it's so nice. And we got to walk out to that. Like, thank goodness for the remote control starter
exactly.
On the car.
Exactly. I got mine going now. Good thing actually wore a winter coat today,
yes.
Too.
And also, today is National Hot Fudge Sunday Day.
Okay. Uh-huh. Did you make Terry Tiberi a Hot Fudge
I will
Sunday?
Be bringing her one home because it's otherwise she likes her Hot Fudge Sundays. Do you like them?
I like all Sundays.
They probably won't melt tonight. Because
they just arrive with okay. It. In the
refrigerator car. Breaks, no big deal. Just throw it in the yard.
Yes, you can. All right, we'll be back with a final check on the weather.
Today we've got my buddy Colin in from Michigan. We're going to have a little bit of fun with him. Welcome to the Buckeye State. With the four-wheel drive, you can literally drive over anything. Speed bumps, potholes, Wolverines. It's the perfect off-road vehicle. The gas mileage is so good, you can just drive on down the field. And check out this amazing sound system.
Do you have it in blue?
Nope, but we do have it in either scarlet or gray.
It's starting to happen every day. People are surprising themselves the moment they realize they can do more with less asthma. Thanks to Dupixent, the add-on treatment for specific types of moderate to severe asthma. Dupixent isn't for sudden breathing problems. It can improve lung function for better breathing in as little as 2 weeks and help prevent severe asthma attacks. It's not a steroid, but can help reduce or eliminate oral steroids. Don't use if allergic to Dupixent. Serious allergic reactions can occur, including anaphylaxis, which is severe. Tell your doctor right away about signs of inflamed blood vessels such as rash, shortness of breath, chest pain, tingling, or numbness in your limbs. Tell your doctor if you have a parasitic infection and before stopping any asthma medicines, including oral steroids. Do more with less asthma. Talk to your doctor about Dupixent.
The end is near. The final days are here for the historic going out of business sale at Front Room Furnishings and 50 Off Furniture. Yes, after 60 years, we're closing forever in a matter of days. With so much inventory still on hand, we invite you to negotiate your best deal. If you're reasonable, it's yours. Negotiate on living rooms, on dining rooms, on bedrooms, on fine leather, mattress sets, and more. If you're reasonable, it's yours. Fine area rugs perfect for any wood floor are an incredible 75% off. The final days mean the greatest saving at Front Room Furnishings and 50 Off Furniture. Buildings for sale, go to frontroombuildings.com.
Add a stylish look to your bathroom and get 11% off everything now at Menards. Update your bathroom with Max. This orchestra freestanding tub has a sleek and minimalist design. Just $7.11 after 11% off. This U-Tile Halo shower kit includes a shower door, base, walls, and shelf. $1,766.65 after 11% off. Save big money on all of your projects and get 11% off everything now at Menards.
Save big money at Menards.
I take my phone, I push a button.
Hey, where's the button?
Dad, it's called an app.
A nap? That sounds like a great idea.
Don't nap on this. Brand new cars starting at only $199 a month, no money down, and a lifetime warranty. The biggest and best selection all at one location with a lifetime warranty on all new vehicles. Plus thousands of certified used cars at the guaranteed lowest prices. And with Express Checkout, save time and money by 100% online with no additional fees. It's just that fast, easy, and fun. We're dealing.
10 TV's Commit to Be Fit is sponsored by Ohio Health, your Central Ohio YMCA, your Columbus and Franklin County Metro Parks, and by Columbus Public Health. 10 TV's Digital Broadcast Center is sponsored by Lindsay Honda.
Tomorrow on 10 This Morning, many of you are already making plans to probably binge watch Disney Plus when it comes out Tuesday. It is the latest in a string of streaming services at your fingertips. But which ones are really worth your money? We're going to break them down one by one. I'm Angela Ann.
And I'm Pete Scalia. Plus, it's going to be brutally cold tomorrow when you start cleaning up the snowfall from tonight. So we'll be on 25 minutes earlier tomorrow morning to help you start your day.
So tune in starting at 4 a.m. tomorrow for all the latest weather conditions.
Getting a blast of winter already. We are under winter weather advisory. You take a look outside your window and probably seeing some snow falling down. That advisory remains in effect until 10 or till 8 o'clock tomorrow morning. But bundle the kids up. We'll be in the 20s tomorrow.
All right. Have a good night and sweet dreams.